restaurant to get some fresh fish for dinner today. So I can get something to eat. I got some shrimp, but I'm gonna try it with squid because I usually get good fish with squid here. Here you throw, in less than a minute, you'll catch a bite. Or you'll catch a fish, one of the two. There it is. It's on me already. Beautiful fish like always. You could eat that fish, but I'd rather get the groupers. Beautiful, but too small. Ah, got one. Let's see what this is. Let's see what this is. It's pulling, it's pulling real hard. Come on. What is this? Ah, snapped it. Snapped the line. Yeah, that fish was real big. I just saw a shadow off of it, but that was it. But now, I'm gonna throw in the same area. See if I get it. Oh, got it again. Oh, this one's coming home. Your 3-pounder. Look at that beautiful fish. That's dinner right there. See, that's the fish I was looking for. I already got my dinner right there. Let's see if I get a couple of more and take some home with me because the season is open. As soon as the bait reached the bottom, that was it. That's all it took. Oh, this is big. Gotta wait it up. Gotta fight it slowly. What is this? It's gotta be big. It's pulling too fast. Come on, buddy. Oh, this is big. Let me tire it. I'm gonna tire it out. Because as soon as it's coming to the top, it snaps my line. Ooh. This nice one. Wow. Look at this one. Woo. This one is humongous. Bigger than the other one. Look at this one. Nice. This is a nice one. And look at this, I still got my bait. How big it is, but this one's gonna have to go away. Too small. This one's gotta be small. It's not pulling that hard. Look at this fish. He is humongous. Look at my hand. Look at his bait. This was his bait. Look at that. This fish is huge. I don't know what kind of fish it is, but his bait was big. Wow. That is big. He almost broke the boat. He's so heavy, he almost broke the boat. Look at this. That's what I'm talking about. That's your big boy right there. This is the biggest fish I caught in the Bahamas. Look at that. Love it. I gotta do cleanup now. Whew, it's a big boy. Finally, he gave up. Whatever it is, he gave up. Nice. Yeah, I'm gonna call it a day because it's 4 o'clock and I don't know where I'm gonna be sleeping tonight. So I'm gonna look for a good spot. That's very important to find a good spot that the wind doesn't hit you hard. Well, I got something within the fishing pole. That was big. Chewed my line up. Look at that. We'll call it a day now.
Thank you.
beautiful sunset it was then. You don't need to have a $300,000 yacht to come here. In a good day, you can come in a 20-footer. Don't do like me, coming on a 19-foot. Come on a 20-footer. The sunset is gone. I'm gonna start cooking. And what I have here is fresh fish. It's already been seasoned. Look at that, beautiful. I'm gonna eat the fish with this great tasting bread here. Look at the sky. This is on my neighbors right there. That smell of fish smells really good. Since I'm gonna toast this bread, I'm gonna cut it in pieces. And now it's time to flip it. Still got a little bit more. Since the fish are whole fish, they're gonna take a little bit longer. Okay, I'm gonna cut a lemon for the fish. And one for the Corona. Okay, it's off. That was a lot of fish for one person. That's amazing. We put some lemon right over it. While it's hot. Beautiful. Now I need to take that hot oil out of there.
so I can toast my bread. It's very dangerous handling hot oil. Okay, that will stay put there. And what I'm gonna do now is turn this thing back on. Grab my bread and just put it right up there. And I will put it on low. That way it doesn't get burned. And of course, nothing goes well. It's very toasted already. Toast is very quick. All I ate today was some chips and a Twix. Seasoning went right to the skin. This fish has a taste more like a lobster. I don't know why, but it tastes like lobster to me. One of my poles is rigged, because tomorrow I'm going to go fishing really early and I need to have my poles fixed to go fishing. Here all I have to do is just attach a hook, because the leader is still in place. So all I have to do is just attach a hook to it and it should be done. I like to use these hooks. Eagle claw. Yeah, I like it. They're really good. I want to get all this done because in the morning, once I do breakfast, I just want to go fishing. I already get a couple of good fish to take home with me, which is really good. Okay, put two loops there. Four loops. One, two, three, and four. Just pull it. There we go. Then hold it right here. Pull real hard. It's not gonna go anywhere. Now, what I gotta do is, and I'm gonna back out from the gasoline that I have behind me here. Yep, definitely back away from the gasoline because we don't wanna make a little spark in here. What I gotta do here is burn that little corner there. Burn that little corner. You see what I did there? I burned that little corner there. That way, if the fish pulls so hard, this little butt here, it's not gonna go anywhere. Great setup right here. Toughest fish won't be able to knock this out. The only thing they can do is bite this leader, which this is 120 pound tested. So, all right.
If you want to check out the setup on my fishing pole, line, hook, I will place the links in the description below.
Better to do these things now than do them tomorrow. These reels are pen. They're the best. You always hear people talking about pen. Well, it's true. Pen reels are amazing. Before, I used to have all the types of brands of reels, but my father recommended me pen, and I gave it a try. And I have never gone back to anything else. So definitely, Pen is a great product. right, it's 11 o'clock at night, and I'm at the back of the deck of the boat. But I have never shown you guys how my boat functions with all my gear in it. Let me show you. Right here, I got my free diving gear. Fuel, some accessories, frying pan. A lot of extra fuel. My navigation light. It's a lot of stuff. We got dual batteries here. Some extra oil there. Here's where I keep my tackle, the big mantis anchor, and some gear. Moving on to the other side. Here I have water tank, and I have a pump there, and I have an auxiliary pump that I use for emergency if I ever have to use it. My shower hose. And in here I have water, fuel, and propane. What a great mixture, propane and fuel. Well, I got water too. Did I mention that? All right. Okay, I got more storage here. BFS ready right here. I have another one handheld. Radio, GPS. All the little things you need. Here I have my fishing rods, my solar panel, got my stove, my pantry, my cooler, which ice lasts there about 3 days, garbage pantry, so I keep my garbage, and on the other side I have the ropes and inflatables to protect the boat. Anchor. And in here, I got my porta potty, all my accessories that I usually need. Everything's here. When I take showers, I take the porta potty out, I take everything out, and that's the drain there to take showers. Then I'll dry everything up, put everything back in here. So, very functional. Okay, moving on to the bedroom. This is where I sleep. Very comfortable. I have a 3-inch air mattress, and I can control the air. So if I want it very stiff, I can do that, or soften it up. Just release the valve. I got my spears there. And that's it. But I'm gonna sleep.
If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching.